His Excellency, Rear Admiral Kevin Scares, Governor of South Australia. Professor Joanne Wright, Acting Vice Chancellor and President. Mr. Bill Cossey, our occasional Speaker. Members of Council, Doctors, Emeritus Professors, Fellows and Senior Management and Staff of the University. Graduands, ladies and gentlemen, as Chancellor of the University of South Australia, I'm delighted to welcome you to this graduation ceremony, and particularly those of you, and there are many here today, who have made a significant effort to be with us. Thank you for doing so. At the outset, I would like to acknowledge that this ceremony is taking place on Kaurna land. The Kaurna people have performed ceremonies on this land for many centuries, and we pay respect to their living culture and the unique role that they continue to play in the life of the Adelaide region. Each year, when I stand here on this stage and I look out on a sea of faces, I feel extremely fortunate to be part of this university and honoured to play some small part in formally starting the next stage of your lives. Outside the auditorium this morning and in here, as you patiently waited for the official party, the sense of excitement and anticipation was quite palpable. But just as evident and significant was the sense of camaraderie and shared achievement. Whatever degree that you have studied and whatever career you're planning, and however keen you are to start the next phase of your life, please take a moment to look back today and congratulate yourself on a job well done. All those long hours and late nights really were worth it. All of us on the stage today and all the university people who've worked with you during your studies share your pride and your joy, as of course do your families and friends. I hope that we've served you well as an institution, and that you find this ceremony a fitting acknowledgement of your time at the University of South Australia as a student. In building your knowledge and skills, it's our goal as a university to equip graduates to make a real and enduring contribution to society. I wish you all the very best in your future endeavours. I'm certain one of the keys to your success has been the love, support and the encouragement of those closest to you, your family and your friends. And I'm sure you're all aware, as certainly I am, that without this support you would not be here today. To demonstrate your appreciation and to thank your family and friends for their invaluable contribution, I'd like to ask you to stand up and face your loved ones and then give them a big clap and a cheer. Thank you, graduands. It's now my pleasure to ask our Acting Vice Chancellor and President, Professor Joanne Wright, to address you.
Thank you, Chancellor, and I join you in welcoming everyone here today. This ceremony is a time of great celebration for you, our graduates, and for the people who have supported you through your studies, your family, your friends, and the university's academic and professional staff. It is your day, and we are honoured to share it. And I know how hard you have all worked to get here today. On average, this university graduates around 9,000 students each year. For our 6,000 undergraduates, to get here today represents somewhere in the order of 2 million hours of classes, 300,000 hours of examinations, 450,000 assignments, and the equivalent of more than 1 billion written words. Our computer people have also calculated that the time spent logged on to our computers is the equivalent of 500 years. That's an awful lot of effort and countless late nights. So congratulations. And what's more, your achievements have been earned in a university that is competing with the best in both Australia and in the world. Just last week, the Australian government published the results of the latest audit of the quality of research undertaken in Australian universities. It revealed that 86% of our assessed research was world class or better. Our physical chemistry and resources engineering and extractive metallurgy received the highest possible ranking, significantly above world standard. At the broad level, our research in commerce, management, tourism and services, and in applied economics was judged to be at world standard. Much of our other research in health sciences, the humanities, and in science and technology was assessed as at or above world standard. And this research was done by the very same people who have taught and assessed you. In international ranking tables, the University of South Australia is rising rapidly. In the 2012 QS World University Rankings of universities aged under 25, the University of South Australia is ranked number 11 in the world. So you can all be confident that as you start to make your mark in your chosen professions and careers, that you have been prepared as well as anyone. In 2012, the university also received its best ever results in student evaluations of teaching and the student experience. And we have plans to make this even better with new buildings, new facilities, and some major investment in university sport and cultural activities. I'm very proud of these achievements, as are all my colleagues. But we are very, very aware of the part that you, our students, have played in stimulating and participating in our research and providing feedback on your experiences. So I hope that as you celebrate your well-deserved individual success, you will also celebrate our collective success. Now, a Vice-Chancellor is usually expected to give graduates a piece of advice as they set out on the next stage of their lives. And my piece of advice to you all is to take any opportunity that comes your way, no matter how daunting it may seem at the time. Just like many of you, aged 17, I left my family and my home to study in a new country where I knew no one. Several years later, I will always remember the very first lecture that I gave at the University of Melbourne as a very young and inexperienced PhD graduate. The subject was military strategy. And when I walked into the room, I saw that a general and a rear admiral were amongst my students. But as well as being extremely scary, this was my opportunity to establish myself as a new academic. and seeing challenging situations as opportunities is largely what has led me to be here giving this graduation address as Acting Vice Chancellor of this fine university. The world is facing many challenges, and the global community needs you to see these as opportunities. Having seen what you can achieve here, I am hugely optimistic that the great challenges of sustainable energy, food supply, nuclear proliferation, aging populations, and cancer will all start to crumble under your collective creativity. I hope you take the time to stay in contact with your friends and colleagues at the University of South Australia, just as we will keep in touch with you. When you have formally completed your journey by walking across this stage and receiving your parchment from the Chancellor, we will be honoured to count you among our more than 170,000 alumni worldwide. Yours is a significant achievement, one that has been hard-earned and thoroughly deserved. Congratulations to you all, and please accept my very best wishes for your future happiness. Thank you.
Thank you, Acting Vice Chancellor. It's now my great pleasure to invite Mr. Bill Cossey AM, Board Chairman, University of South Australia Councillor, to deliver today's occasional address. During his 38-year public service career, Mr. Cossey has held a number of senior positions within state government departments, and before his retirement in 2004, he was Chief Executive of the State Courts Administration Authority. Prior to serving in that role, he was Deputy Chief Executive of the Department of Industry and Trade and Chief Executive Officer of the Adelaide Festival Centre Trust. Today, Mr. Cossey continues to serve on the governing councils of the University of South Australia, which he is leaving very shortly, the Adelaide Benevolent Society, and the Eastern Waste Management Authority. He also chairs the boards of the Energy and Water Ombudsman's Office, Tennis SA, the Don Dunstan Foundation, and People's Choice Credit Union. In 2004, Mr. Cossey was made a member of the Order of Australia for services to the government and to the community. Please welcome Mr. Bill Cossey.
Thank you, Chancellor. Thank you also to the University for affording me the honour of delivering this occasional address at this important graduation ceremony. Good morning, everyone. I'm particularly honoured to be speaking today in the presence of His Excellency, the Governor of South Australia, this morning. I've been privileged to serve the University of South Australia for the past 10 years as a member of its Governing Council. And I assure you all that the graduands we are honouring today have experienced a high quality education experience at an outstanding university. And to the graduands from overseas who have chosen to study in Adelaide, I trust that your experience of studying and living in Adelaide has been all that you wished for. It is almost 45 years since I sat at my own graduation ceremony in a prestigious building at another university at the other end of North Terrace. At the time of my study, it was the only university in South Australia. I have no memory of who gave the occasional address or what that person said, so I therefore have very little expectation that as graduands today, you'll remember a lot about this address in years to come either. So I've resisted the temptation to give you a lecture on the do's and don'ts of the world beyond university. Instead, I've decided to tell you two stories, each of which emphasises a point which I found useful in my working life and which I hope is also useful for you. The first story relates to Barry Koski, the artistic director of the 1996 Adelaide Festival of Arts. Barry was a very young man in his early 30s at that time. The marketing people at the Adelaide Festival office decided it would be a good idea if Barry gave a speech about the Adelaide Festival of Arts at a business lunch on a Friday at the Function Centre at Football Park. This was a very well attended lunch, about 500 people, mostly sales representatives entertaining their clients, and it was quite obvious that very few of them had any intention of returning to work after the lunch. The noise in the room was very loud indeed, and Barry's speech was scheduled for late in the lunch program, by which time the noise had reached a crescendo. The host of the lunch introduced Barry in much the same way as the Chancellor has just introduced me. To polite applause from the official table, but not many others in the room, Barry went to the stage and stood behind the microphone. There was no reduction at all to the noise in the room. Barry just stood there, saying nothing. He stood there for what seemed an eternity, still saying nothing. Eventually, curiosity got the better of most people in the audience and the room quietened down. When it reached an acceptably low level of noise, Barry simply said, "Thank you. My parents always told me not to speak when others were speaking." Slightly more applause followed. For the next 20 minutes, Barry did not talk about the Adelaide Festival. Realising that this audience was mainly interested in sport, Barry told them stories about his times at Melbourne Grammar School, a school renowned for producing good sports people, and how he had been required to try every sport the school offered and fail miserably at each of them before he could pursue his dream of being an artist. The stories were hilarious. The audience was captivated and he could have talked for hours, such was their engagement with him. I don't recall the detail of all the stories, but I do remember him saying that he knew he'd reached the last sport, tennis, winter tennis in Melbourne. Not a great prospect given Melbourne's winter climate. In the last 3 minutes of that speech, Barry simply told them how important the festival was to Adelaide, encouraged them to read the festival program, and offered 2 free tickets to anyone who could not find a show that might interest them. The applause at the end of his speech was thunderous and in stark contrast to the muffled applause when he was first introduced. It was an astonishing performance. It is possible that in your studies you have come across the work of Stephen Covey. He wrote a best-selling book, The 7 Habits of Highly Effective People. Habit number 5 of these 7 habits is stated as, seek to understand before you seek to be understood. Barry Koski understood exactly who he was speaking to, what they'd be interested in, the power of storytelling and of humour. He understood all of that before he sought to convey to his audience what he wanted them to understand. This is a very powerful habit of highly effective people. My second story deals with an American presenter whose name I've long since forgotten at a seminar in the mid-1970s in Adelaide organised by the Australian Computer Society. This was the first major seminar organised by the Society in Adelaide and expectations were huge as the subject matter was extremely topical at the time. There were about 350 professional people in the audience. Again, the presenter was warmly introduced, but this time to very generous applause. He fiddled with his microphone, then mumbled something about being pleased to be presenting, and then turned his back on the audience and started scribbling mathematical equations in very small print on a whiteboard, all the time continuing to mumble away as if talking to himself. The president of the Computer Society, who was a very well-known former head of computer science at this university and a man not known for his patience, was seen racing to the door, no doubt to find and complain to whoever had sourced this presenter. Some enthusiasts in the front row desperately tried to take notes from these mathematical equations, but almost no one else in the room could either read the scribble on the whiteboard or hear the presenter anyway. After about 3 or 4 minutes of this, people in the audience started talking amongst themselves, someone from the back of the room yelled out to the presenter to speak up, a request that was met with a chorus of approval from the audience. At this point, the presenter turned up his microphone, turned back to the audience, and in a very clear voice said, "I'm afraid to tell you that what you have just experienced is what users of computer systems experience from their computer system design professionals every day." Of course, the rest of the presentation was extremely professional and all was forgiven. The message for me from this experience was the importance of communication, whether it is verbal, written, or electronic, being in a style and using language that is easily understood by the receivers of the communication. As part of your studies, you will have been introduced to some quite complex concepts, and you will draw on these in your working life beyond university. Your success will as much depend on your ability to explain these concepts in ways that are understandable to people who may not have had the same educational opportunities or experiences as you have had. There is no shame in being able to simplify complex concepts, quite the contrary. As was mentioned in the introduction, I worked for 5 years in the State Courts Administration Authority, and in that role had the pleasure of spending quite a bit of time with now retired Chief Justice John Doyle. John Doyle is such a master of the English language and of the law that he can explain complex legal points in the most simple of language. In his written word, hardly a sentence is more than 2 lines long, and hardly a word contains more than 3 syllables. Another useful lesson for me has been that the more you understand something, the easier it is to write or talk simply about it. And one final message as you interact with people in your future workplaces and in life. A very wise person once said, "People don't always remember what you say or do, but they always remember how you make them feel." The most influential people I've known make people feel included, feel valued, and feel open to more engagement and interaction. Thank you for listening to me today. Congratulations on your academic achievements. I wish you every success in your careers and in life generally. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Cossey, for that very wise address. I'm sure you will agree. I'd now like to invite Professor Christine Hellier, Head of the School of Commerce, to begin the presentation of awards.
Chancellor, I present to you the candidates who have filled the conditions for admission to awards of this university. I request that awards be conferred in absentia upon the other candidates whose names appear in the graduation ceremony handbook.
Professor Hellier, I have pleasure in conferring awards on all candidates who have complied with the prescribed requirements.
Thank you. For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Fei Mo, by thesis entitled Transmission of Monetary Policy and Its Effects on the Stock Market in China. Chancellor, I present Dr. Mo. For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Lara Stocky. By thesis entitled Exploring the Link Between Consumer Behaviour and Brand Associations. Chancellor, I present Dr. Stocky. For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Abdul Rahim Zumrah, by thesis entitled The influence of perceived organisational support on transfer of training and the consequences of transfer of training on service quality and job satisfaction, a Malaysian public sector context. Chancellor, I present Dr. Zumra. Chancellor, I present awards in the Division of Business. The sole candidate for the degree of Bachelor of Commerce Honours, Lian Wei Dong. The sole candidate for the degrees of Bachelor of Applied Finance and Bachelor of Management Marketing, Chun Him Wong. The sole candidate for the degrees of Bachelor of Business, International Business, Finance and Trade, and Bachelor of Commerce, Tu Su Tran. For the degree of Master of Business, Professional Accounting and Finance, Bai Li Shui. Kai Wen Yao. Chen Xinxin. Saeed Mohammed Fahim. Feng Chao Wei. Yao Gao, Yang Gao, Go Yun Hill, Ting Ting Huang. Bin Jia. Jianlong Yu Jun. Yan Jia Lai. Lei Jin Ying. Ru Yi Li, Pham Xuan Lan, Wan Ruxu, Shan Shan Wang. Wang Xiaojia. Wu Zhuxin. Yu Xingyong. Wen Zhao. The sole candidates for the degree of Master of Business, Professional Accounting and Specialization, Xu Jujun. For the degree of Master of Professional Accounting, Chai Yan. Huang Yu Jie. Chi Wing Kong. Ricking Michael Christie. Ti Hai An Lei. Yitting Mo. For the degree of Master of Professional Accounting and Finance, Piying Yang. Jing Yu Yu. Ruhan Ju. The sole candidate for the Graduate Diploma in Professional Accounting, Nguyen Thi Tu Hang. For the degrees of Bachelor of Commerce and Bachelor of Applied Finance, Tong Viet Nguyen. Thuy Lien Nguyen. For the degree of Bachelor of Applied Finance, Chen Gonggi. Chen Yiwei. Pun Chi Hung Desmond. Chong Jae Mei. Ying Suet Chow. Han Wei. Hen Kim Guan. Yikai Hu. Hu Yue. Hu Yulin. Huang Yubin. Huang Zhe. Jiang Dai. Li Qing. Dawn Can Huey. Pei Ting Ko. Kong Liung. Xin Chi Kong. Georgi Kuruks. Siet Chung Lan. Wai Xing Lan. Lao Yin Min. Li Jun. Li Chi. Li Xiaoji. Lim Jun Wei. Jai Liu. Chiuk Hot Liu. Lu Ying. Divine Madaya. Nguyen Quoc Trung Hung. Hai Yuan Peng. Duc Dan Trua Phan. Chin Su Wei. Tan Vu Tien Kwa. Reshmi Rakajasakaran. Haya Tao Shen. Xiao Wanxi. Song Hang. Tay Ru Yin. Son Min Tan. Toon Mayun. Pyong Ti Tan Tran. Dang Hai Trin. Yi De Wang. Wang Yu Chen. Hang Wen. Gai Yuan Xiang. Xu Ximru. Yap Yen Li. Yeo Anjul Wun Huai. Yu Su. Jiang Qian. Zhao Bing. Chong Jia. The sole candidate for the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration, Tu An Vuong. The sole candidate for the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration Marketing, Doc Jia Cheng. For the degree of Bachelor of Business, International Business, Vin Bao Ngoc Duan. Ching Guo. And Hua Jia Cheng. For the degree of Bachelor of Business, International Business, Finance and Trade, Jia Qi Hung. Zhu Chao. Shalini Manoharan. And Hector Palomares Iglesias. For the degree of Bachelor of Business Property, Lawrence Chin Chao Ming. Jia Hao Li. Lim Lu Fong. Ng Jeng Hong. Even Tan. Di Xin. Chancellor, this concludes the first part of the presentation of awards.
Thank you, Professor Hellier. I now invite Professor Milay Terzijowski, head of the International Graduate School of Business, to continue with the presentation of awards.
For the degree of Bachelor of Commerce, Ang Eng Loon. Bu Chun Ming. Wei On Chan, Chen Long, Cheng Yao, Ho Ting Chung. Chia Shu Ting, Benjamin Ka Wei Chong, Chong Jay An, Justin Chung Wanjian. Chao Kuen Kong. Samane Deganian. Duan Ti Tao Wing. Du Xuan. Fan Meng. Xian Liang Fan. Fong Chi Yan. Fu Junyu. Wei Ji. Han Yan. He Zijun. Mi Hua Ha. Ho Wei Fen. Yu Yang. Ming Min Huang. Niket Jinjuwala. Jiang Qing. Kayin Ken Kun. Lai Qian Ying. Samuel Lazeri. Tran Ming Fuang Li. Chung Ting Li. Li Guang Shi. Wei Chung Ivan Li. Chan Juan Li. Li Ka Fei. Sha Li. Shu Huan Li. Liang Yang Ling. Liang Yilong. Lim Chu Shik. Hao Han Lin. Chu Chong Leong. Oscar Yin Fung Lok. Lo Yin Chen. Lulu. Mark Wai Moon. Avinash Mandhan. Edwina Masang. Molisha. Sayhabuddin Mohammed Mood. Te Ying Zhou Yang N. Win Yung Wang Fuk. Tan Fuong Win. Jin Yuan Ouyang. Min Peng. Chu Hei To. Chu Kirkshin. Ahmad Huzaifi Ezrael bin Sherahul Azwa. Pei Fang Tan. Dennis Ching Tung Tang. Tang Yang. Ting Chan Kathy. Win Tai Tang Tran. Tai Tian Lai Tran. Yuan Man Chu. Chayan Wong. Xiling Wu. Xu Shou. Shui Fei. Yap Chin Ho. Liang Zhai. Zhang Han Yuan. Zha Tian. Zhu Hao. And Fatin Sayazana Zulkifli. for the degree of Le Cordon Bleu Master of International Hospitality Management, Arben Berko Cardigo. Sunisa Domhom. Minyan Fan. Yizhu Jiang. Shan Shan Jin. Ying Ying Li. Chungwang Su. And Meng Zhao. For the degree of Master of Human Resource Management, Liu Kaiyan Angel. James Chua. And Ren Fan. The sole candidate for the degree of Master of Management, Kiyao Yo. The sole candidate for the degree of Master of Management, Administrative Management, Irene Aileen Lo. For the degree of Master of Management, Integrated Supply Chain Management, Kang Fei. And Xiao Jian Gang. For the degree of Bachelor of Management, Chen Hui. And He Huan. For the degree of Bachelor of Management, Human Resource Management, Sumaya Mohammed Al-Sadan. Okay. Marie Ophelie Gilda Rachel Doris Hopel. And Zhaoying Liu. For the degree of Bachelor of Management, Logistics and Supply Chain Management, Xiao Liang. Senghao Ng. Wang Lu. And Zhang Guanghao. For the degree of Bachelor of Tourism and Event Management, Jiaming Chan. Ying Rui Chang. Tuen Thang Dang. Wen Feng Ho. Liu Nan. Siumen. Guowen Sun. Tang Tzu Hin. Wang Guang Song. Wang King Man. Chipin Wu. Zhao Qiang Yu. For the degree of Master of Marketing, Naman Ahmad. Ruan Chihong. Wang Yang. And Jiang Yui. For the degree of Bachelor of Management Marketing, Nurain Binti Aini. Ka Chun Chan. Dian Chen. Chu Er Yong. Yu Ji Qing. Fan Ping Chuan. Yu Fang. Ka Chun Fu. Yuki Hashimoto. Kellyn Ho. Nigel Tang Ying Ke. Ko Ke Ching. Kwa Li Hui. Lo Guan Yu. Qiang Lim. Ta Lung Lim. Liu Lin. Chan Liu. Nguyen Chin. Shiwa Yu Pan.
Excuse me.
So Joe Wynn. Yuan Ting Seto. Tae-aik Min. Teo Jin Hung. Ting Ting Wang. Kay Ka Wong. Wu Si Ching. Xu Hui Ling. Yo Ka Wei. And Xiao Hui Zhong. The sole candidate for the degree of a Bachelor of Marketing and Communication, Kui Dui Truong. For the degree of Le Cordon Bleu Master of Business Administration, International Hotel and Restaurant Management, Fanny Cynthia Dewey. And Kyung Hee Ju. For the degree of Master of International Business, Ding Li Chang. And Li Jin. Chancellor, this concludes the presentation of awards.
Thank you, Professor Tyziowski. I'm sure that everyone today here shares the sense of success, success of our graduates and the pride in their families and their friends in this significant achievement in their academic and professional careers. Graduates, you've shared one of the most significant periods of your life with your colleagues at the University of South Australia. And as the reputation and renown of the university continues to grow, so too is the value of the qualification that you worked so hard to achieve. So be it further enhanced. I hope that you'll choose to continue your association with this institution. You can do that through the Alumni Network, which offers the opportunity for ongoing contact with your colleagues and participation in the life and the story of the university. And now, I'd like the graduates to remain seated while the rest of us in this assembly stand to congratulate them in the traditional manner.